guys, in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you all of these sunscreens that I finished up over the course of the winter time, we'll say. As a reminder, I do have a fairly recent video on all of the non-sunscreen skincare products that I made my way through and finished up, so check that out. But first and foremost, I finished the CeraVe Hydrating Sunscreen SPF 30. This is their tinted mineral sunscreen. Love it. It's very moisturizing. It gives the skin a nice glow. I like that it is tinted because tinted sunscreens are actually a little bit better in terms of the extent of protection that they afford you in comparison to non-tinted sunscreens. Why? Well, they have iron oxides. Iron oxides are ingredients in sunscreens that can protect you against something called HEV. What the heck is that? Well, that's a part of visible light, the light that you see with your eyes, in the blue light spectrum that we have learned generates a lot of free radical damage in the skin, contributing to photoaging. And in people with medium to deep skin types, that HEV light actually contributes to early onset and more stubborn hyperpigmentation. So selecting a tinted sunscreen is one way that you can protect against those wavelengths. Sunscreens, by and large, are meant to protect you against ultraviolet radiation from the sun. That's what burns your skin and, you know, contributes to aging and skin cancer risk. But they don't really have to protect you against those propigmenting wavelengths of visible light, the HEV wavelengths. Now, ingredients in sunscreens that protect against that are, like I said, iron oxides. Zinc oxide and mineral sunscreens, to a certain extent, can protect against those wavelengths, but the smaller the zinc, the less likely it is to protect you against those wavelengths. And in order for zinc to really protect you against HEV, it's gotta be pretty large. And in that case, you're looking at a sunscreen that's gonna end up giving you a pretty strong white cast. So iron oxides, you know, they can step in, they can help protect against those HEV wavelengths, such as in this tinted sunscreen. Although, unfortunately, you'll never know really to what extent the sunscreen is gonna protect you against those HEV wavelengths, because manufacturers, they don't really have to measure that or report it. And it boils down to a few things. The concentration of iron oxides in the product, which you're never gonna know, you can't guess that just by looking at the ingredient list. The types of iron oxides, there are actually a few different types. There's black, red, and yellow. And each of these different types of iron oxides has a different peak absorption within the blue light spectrum. So having a blend of black, red, yellow iron oxides can actually kind of get you a little bit more of a comfortable buffer, if you will, of protection against those HEV wavelengths. And then, of course, as with everything in sunscreen, it boils down to formulation overall. So you're never going to be able to just look at the ingredient list and figure out how good a sunscreen is at protecting you against those HEV wavelengths. Unfortunately, manufacturers do not have to report that. There are some assays that they can do, but the majority do not do that. So all that being said, I do recommend people, especially people who are dealing with hyperpigmentation, select tinted sunscreens. You'll see here I go through quite a few, and this is one that I really like. It's good for medium skin tones. It is a little bit of an, it does have a little bit of an orange-ish hue. So if you're really pale, this, you know, may not work for you, but I really enjoy it. It's got ceramides in it, which are helpful for the moisture barrier. And it also has niacinamide, which is anti-inflammatory. It can help calm down redness and also helps with reducing the hyperpigmentation issue as well. So that is a really good one. All right, next up, I finished a longtime favorite of mine, the Colorescience Sun Forgettable Total Face Shield. I've been using this product for years now. I love it. I go through one or two a year of this particular product. It is a tinted mineral sunscreen. It's a nice liquid fluid consistency. The tint on this is not as deep as the CeraVe one. It's better for paler skin tones. It has a really natural finish without being shiny or greasy. So this is a longtime favorite of mine. Now, Colorescience came out with a few new products this year that they actually sent me. I was excited to try them. They are sponsoring this portion of today's video while I tell you about these products. All right, first of all is their Even Up Multi-Correction Serum. Now, I first read about this a while ago actually. And what it is a lightweight serum. It's very moisturizing. It contains their patented Lumera ingredient blend of like peptides and lipids. And this particular product actually has been shown in a 12-week clinical study to improve not only skin hydration, but skin tone, and to improve hyperpigmentation. The researcher actually showed that their MASI score improved, which is basically a way of evaluating the extent of melasma severity. So they had improvement in their hyperpigmentation with this product, both subjectively and objectively, throughout the 12-week study. Not only does it help address issues of hyperpigmentation, but it's very moisturizing. Because of its lightweight consistency, the other thing that I like about this is that it's easy to pair with your sunscreen. You guys know a lot of times you'll try and put on like a moisturizer or something, and then when you put your sunscreen on over, it pills and doesn't, you know, stay on, which is a problem because in that case you're not getting good protection. This is very lightweight, it absorbs really quickly into the skin, helping to improve skin hydration and skin tone, and then you can pair it with your sunscreen. And then they also sent me their Even Up Clinical Pigment Perfector SPF 50, which I'm currently wearing. I've been wearing it now for a few weeks and I really like it. This particular sunscreen is definitely worth paying attention to. One of the things that stood out to me the most when I first put it on is how amazing the coverage is. You can really get some very nice cosmetic camouflage with this product. It's actually pretty high coverage, almost, I won't say like a foundation, but somewhere in between a tinted moisturizer and a foundation as far as the extent of coverage that you get. So if you have dark spots, things that you're trying to camouflage, maybe you're trying to back away from makeup a little bit, definitely give this a try. It's very good.
The Even Up Clinical Perfector SPF 50 is actually primarily a hyperpigmentation treatment with the same level of that Lumera complex as the serum to treat dark spots.
What I love the most about this though is that Colorescience actually has assayed the extent of blue light protection in this product. It has three different types of iron oxides, black, red, and yellow. I'll put a reference to the study down below in the description box, but this particular sunscreen, they looked at three different wavelengths across the HEB kind of spectrum, and at each of those wavelengths, this particular sunscreen blocked anywhere from 71.9 to 82%. That's very, very good. And so, you know, we actually have something here that we can hang our hat on as far as the level of protection against pro-pigmenting wavelengths of visible light. It has been estimated that about 50% of the free radicals that are generated in our skin when we're exposed to the sun are actually due to HEB wavelengths, not UV. I mean, UV is a major contributor, don't dismiss it, but it's the HEB that we have now learned are really playing, those wavelengths are really playing a major role in skin aging. Yeah, I'm wearing it right now. I really like it. It doesn't like pill, it doesn't look greasy. And as I said, it's kind of somewhere in between a tinted moisturizer and a full-on foundation as far as the extent of coverage that it provides. Yeah, it's very good. Highly recommend it. Thank you, Colorescience, for sponsoring this portion of today's video. All right, I also finished up another tube of the MDSolar Sciences SPF 50. It does not leave a cast on my skin. If you have a medium to deep skin tone though, this will leave that kind of lavender ashen look. But I love this two bits. My only gripe is I wish that it were in slightly different packaging because I find that the tube, you know, it's harder to get every last drop. Yes, I know you can cut the top off, but I think I actually did end up getting the majority out. It's just, you end up, you know, kind of wasting it. So I wish they had slightly different packaging, but otherwise I adore this. It's very good. If you have a paler skin type, especially if you have a deeper skin tone though, I would say skip this. Instead, try their SPF 30. Their SPF 30, I currently have a bottle that's about halfway finished with. That has a deeper tint to it. But this is very good overall. It doesn't, you know, again, it doesn't pill, it doesn't ball. Now this one's got more of a silicone base to it than some of the others that I've talked about. So it has kind of a pore blurring effect. It's very good at slowing down water loss out of the skin. But if you don't like that, silicone heavy things, you may not care for this. But for me, I have always adored it. All right, another sunscreen that I make my way through pretty much every season is the DRMTLGY Universal Tint. This is, again, another tinted mineral sunscreen. And this one's got zinc, it's actually a combination sunscreen. So it's got zinc oxide, and then it has a chemical filter, octinoxate, which will protect against UVB. And then it does have iron oxides, although again, we're not told how much, or you know, there's no assay behind their iron oxide formulation to tell us how good it is at protecting against pro-pigmenting wavelengths of light. But all that being said, this is a longtime favorite. I happen to think this is very good if you have medium to deepish skin tone. A lot of people with deeper skin tones have reported they love this, they love the way it looks, but a lot of people with deeper skin tones are like, no, it still leaves kind of a lavender look to the skin. So I wanna put that out there. I don't want you guys to feel like, you know, I don't wanna make it seem as though this is completely cast-free, but it does look really good on most skin types. Give it a try. It has an odd odor to it. I can't explain, it's like a pool float, but that fades right away. This is very good if you have oily skin. It's not greasy, it's not shiny. I love it to bits. It also has niacinamide in it, which is good for calming down redness. It's a favorite. I also finished the Neostrata Sheer Physical Protection. This is a mineral sunscreen with, again, tinted. Now this one is a good one if you have a paler skin type. This is not good if you have a deeper skin type because this still leaves a cast. Even on my skin type, you can still see a cast. But I really like the texture of this. It's very similar to the Exuviance color correcting product. It used to be called the Exuviance Sheer Mineral Daily, but they rebranded it. Same product though. Yeah, this is very similar. Again though, if you have a medium to deep skin tone, I don't think the tint on this is particularly good. You know, it's still casty, even on my skin type. All right, so those are all, you can see I was pretty heavy with the tinted sunscreens. I do have some non-tinted sunscreens though. I finished up this. It is the Cotz Silky Foam. Now this is a mineral foam sunscreen. I did not care for this. It was very sticky. Goes on, feels very moisturizing when you're putting it on, which is nice. You know, sometimes mineral sunscreens, they can be very drying. So I use this a lot on my body, but I found that it would leave the skin very sticky. This actually was sent to me. I don't know who sent it to me. It came to my PO box. So if you sent it to me, thank you. But yeah, I don't know. It's not my favorite Cotz product. I love Cotz though. They have a lot of very good sunscreens, but this I would say is a skip. Sticky consistency and yeah, it just was not my favorite. And then last but not least, I finished two sunscreens from a Black Girl Sunscreen. Their kids love this. Now this is not a mineral sunscreen. This is a chemical sunscreen. So there's no cast with this. You know, if you're looking for a sunscreen, you're like, just name me a sunscreen that's not gonna leave a cast. Look at the ingredients. If the active ingredients don't say titanium or zinc, and then you look at the inactive ingredients and you don't see titanium or zinc, there's a good chance that it's not gonna leave a cast. It's a chemical sunscreen. And this is a chemical sunscreen. There's no zinc, there's no titanium dioxide. It's their kids formula. It's like under $10. No cast, water resistant. I adore this. You know, some people find that the chemical sunscreens burn or sting. This did not burn or sting for me. Put it around my eyes comfortably. And I like that it's inactive ingredients to have like jojoba seed oil and shea butter. It gives the skin a very nice glow without being greasy or oily or shiny. This is amazing. I just wish they sold it in a bigger bottle because I ended up using it not only on my face but on my body, so I went through it pretty quickly. And then most recently I finished their newer Make It Matte. This is SPF 45, also water resistant like the kids one. This one, unlike the kids, comes out as a colorless product. So it obviously goes on with no cast. The kids one just comes out like a white cream, but this is more of like a little color, like a colorless, almost a gel. And like the kids one, it's very emollient. It gives the skin a nice glow. So this one, it kind of reminds me actually of the Supergoop Unseen sunscreen, but with a little bit more of a glow factor to it. So I really liked it, but I felt like I went through it quickly, and then once I got to a certain point in this, it became very difficult to get the product out because it's one of these airless pump containers, and I got to a point where I would pump and nothing would come out. So I had to take the top off and dump it out into my hand. Yeah, so this packaging is challenging. It's problematic. At least mine, you know, maybe I got a dud. I was not able to get the remains out without actually taking the top off and dumping it out into my hand. And I had only made it through probably about a third of the product before I started having to do that and having issues with the pump. Now the DRMTLGY tinted sunscreen that I showed you at the beginning, this is in one of these pump bottles too. And I've never had a problem getting product out of this. It lasts me, you know, several months of using it daily, and then it's done. So yeah, this one, I don't know if they have a tube that goes all the way down to the end. Fortunately, it does seem like I'm able to get all of it out because this, unlike the Black Girl matte, you can't actually take the top off. So I don't know. Maybe I do have product left behind in here and I just don't know, but yeah. So those are all the sunscreens that I finished up. Some really good ones here. Comment below what sunscreens you're currently using and loving. I always like hearing that from you guys. Thank you, Colorescience, for sponsoring a portion of today's video. Check in the description box. I will link all the sunscreens I mentioned today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.